Ladies and gentlemen, we have the three panelists today. And Yang Berhormat Dr. Syed Azman Syed Ahmad Nawawi, representing International Bureau of Islamic Party Malaysia. And he will be focusing on mobilizing the international demand for freeing Baitul Maqdis, inshallah. So without further ado, I would like to call upon Yang Berhormat Dr. Syed Azman Syed Ahmad Nawawi.
Security concern in relation to it. so-called sovereignty. My dear brothers and sisters, the land of Palestine, Israel has occupied for more than 6 decades. Israel is an aggressive and aggressor state. It implements an apartheid system whereby we can see throughout the Palestinian occupation the persistent denial of the UN sanctioned rights of Palestine refugees, right to reparation and to return to their homes of origin that is in accordance with UNGA Resolution 194. The ongoing ethnic cleansing, we know that and we realize that, the system of racial discrimination against Palestine citizens in the so-called occupied Palestine that they call it Israel, and the prolonged occupation and colonization of Gaza and West Bank, including Bayt al-Maqdis and other Arab territories. My dear brothers, these are some of the systematic displacement of our brothers and sisters in the Holy Land of Palestine. The demolition of houses, the forced eviction of our Palestinian families, military operation with no grounds of military necessity, land confiscation and colonization, and also violence by the Jewish settlers in the occupied Palestine. And also the closure by the regime, including lack of access to basic services and supplies to our Palestinian families in the occupied land. For the Zionist Israel, their main purpose is to grab the maximum amount of land, including Bayt al-Maqdis, with a minimum number of indigenous Palestinians. My dear brothers and sisters, what are the consequences for the Palestinian people? We can look at this map, the stages that the Holy Land being grabbed by the Zionist Israel. From stage one, stage two, stage three, and today, we can see how sophisticated the Zionist Israel has taken our Holy Land in Palestine. And now they have built the separation wall. You have to realize that the separation wall completely surrounds more than 100,000 people in 42 towns. It reduced the availability of water supply by 1 billion gallons. It confiscated hundreds of thousands of acres of land. It severely restricted travel to jobs, hospital, and school, and adversely affected 4 out of 10 Palestinians in the occupied land of Palestine. let us look at the comparison. Can we compete in the economic and military might of the Zionist state of Israel? I will be precise on this. We look at the economic comparison. The Israel GDP, the Palestinian GDP, the per capita income of our Palestinian brothers, and also the per capita income of the Israelis. Let us compare and look at the unemployment in Israel and unemployment of our Palestinian brothers and sisters in the occupied land. A Palestinian has to work for 28 years to earn what an Israel does in 1 year. In terms of military might, military comparison, the Israeli and the Palestinian, they have more than 4,000, nearly 4,000 tanks. The Palestinians don't have any tank, combat aircraft, zero. Artillery, zero. Military expenditure, more than 33 billion per annum. And our Palestinian brothers and sisters, they spend only around 100 million in terms of military expenditure. The official active forces, more than 200,000 active forces in Israel as compared to around 55,000 among the Palestinians. My dear brothers and sisters, the reality, the freedom of Israel, for them is inside hatred. As been quoted by Ayman Sofer, chair of the Geo Strategy and also vice chair of the Center of National Security Studies. He said, when 2.5 million Palestinians live in the close of Gaza, these people will become even bigger animals than they are today. If we want to remain alive, we will have to kill and kill and kill all day and every day. Dr. Haim Yacoubi from Ben Gurion University quoted that the Judaism project is driven by the Zionist premise that Israel is a territory and a state that belong to and only to the Jewish people. So my dear brothers and sisters, what are the current situation? Can we mobilize the international community to regain the freedom of Baitul Maqdis? Will the Arab world relook its policy towards the liberation of Baitul Maqdis? These are the two pertaining questions that we have to answer, and the Muslim Ummah has to answer. Can boycott generate freedom? We have done this, boycotting Israel good. To a certain extent, we have done by boycotting Israeli institutions. Is it effective? Is it workable? And can we move forward by just boycotting Israel goods and also institutions? What are the capabilities of the Arab nation, my dear brothers and sisters? The realities are it is weak. Some of the Arab nation leaders are hostile and anti-liberation, and most of them adhere to the US foreign policy. We have read, we have heard, we have listened to many UN resolutions on Palestine. Hundreds of UN resolutions that condemn either the brutality or the aggressiveness of the Zionist Israel. But all of the UN resolution as of today has been ignored by the Zionist state of Israel. In the UN, my dear brothers and sisters, Israel is a nation with a special status. You can condemn, you can bring up as many UN resolutions that you want, but they have a very strong veto power. Very strong, based in terms of support, especially United States and its allies. For our Palestinian brothers, for the Palestinian state, Palestine is not a recognized state of the UN, but representative from PNA speaks as a guide. It has observer status in the UN, given there because there is no legitimate national government for Palestine. My dear brothers, a failure of strategic framework in the Arab world. What happened that we should realize today is lack of comprehensive plan for undermining Israeli and American alliance. The failure to link political goals with an effective withdrawal and no clear idea of the kind of political settlement in the Holy Land of Palestine. And the third one is there is no political will to end the Zionist occupation in the Holy Land of Palestine. Why do we fail, my dear brothers and sisters? Number one, due in large part to the failure of the Palestinians themselves. They have to realize that. Number two, leadership. Leaders of Intifada failed to articulate a clear political platform that could translate the tactical success of resistance into a tangible result, most notably a true Palestinian state. Number three, we have to realize, we have to accept the realities. Weak leadership, including division between Fatah and Hamas, that has resulted in a policy strategy disconnect. And number five, the inactivity and subservience of most Arab member states to the US broken peace plan, PEACE, that became PIECE. What are the solutions, my dear brothers and sisters? We can mobilize the Ummah for a greater awareness. We can have a national reconciliation between Fatah movement and Hamas. The Arab nation, the Arab state, have to relook into its policy on Bayt al-Maqdis and Palestine. And as been proposed by our brothers in a while ago, the Arab states and Muslim nation has to come up with their own peace plan and do not wait for the American peace plan to solve and to resolve the future of the Holy Land of Palestine. What are the future of Palestine, my dear brothers and sisters? We have three main questions in front of us. Is it the independent, viable Palestine state within the 1967 borders? Many arguments, many counter-arguments on this point. Is it for East Jerusalem as the capital of Palestinian state? Many arguments and many counter-arguments on this point. Or is it the total liberation of the Holy Land of Palestine? My dear brothers and sisters, our responsibility and the responsibility of the Muslim Ummah The way to return the land and liberate Baitul Maqdis is through desire, resistance, and self-sacrifice. There is no other way. Baitul Maqdis and Palestine, from the land, from the sea to the river, belong to the Palestinian people, the Arabs and the Muslims. No one has the authority to concede a grain of earth, wall or stone from this holy land. Its stones, olives and figs are sacred, and no one has the right to give it up. This land must belong to its owners, and it will return, God willing, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.